Welcome back, fellow scientists. It's Justin and Mia again. We're getting ready for our vacation to Guayaquil, Ecuador. I've always wanted to go. I just need to check the weather so we know what to pack. Wait, this can't be right. 88 degrees in December? December's in winter, so it's usually freezing this time of year. Maybe the website's wrong. Let's check Ecuador's average weather for other months. March, 89 degrees. June, 85 degrees. September, still in the 80s. How is that possible? Earth is always rotating and revolving, so why doesn't every place experience the same seasonal changes? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to explain why we have different seasons and what changes we experience during different seasons. Let's investigate. We know that Earth follows a path around the sun. Scientists, what's that path called? Yes, an orbit. And how long does it take for Earth to complete one full revolution around the sun? 365¼ days. That's one whole year. As Earth orbits the sun, it moves through four seasons: summer, fall, winter, and spring. But Earth's orbit is only part of the reason for these changes. There's something else that plays a big role too. Take a look. Our planet isn't straight up and down, it's tilted at an angle. This tilt plays a huge role in how different places experience seasons as Earth orbits the sun. So, Earth's tilted axis and revolution around the sun explain why it's freezing where I live, but hot in Ecuador? Let's take a closer look and see how this really works. The tilt of Earth's axis affects how the sun's light hits the Earth. The amount of sunlight changes throughout the year. When one half of the Earth, called a hemisphere, tilts toward the sun, it gets more direct sunlight, meaning the light is more concentrated and delivers more heat, making temperatures warmer. During this time, that hemisphere also experiences longer daylight hours because of the sun's position in the sky. Since the hemisphere is tilted towards the sun appears higher in the sky and takes a longer path across it, meaning it rises earlier and sets later. This results in longer days and shorter nights compared to other times of the year. The hemisphere tilted toward the sun would be experiencing summer at this time. Earth remains tilted as it revolves around the sun, which is what causes the transition between seasons. So, when a hemisphere tilts away from the sun, it receives indirect sunlight. Indirect sunlight is spread out, delivering less heat and making it colder. The hemisphere tilted away from the sun also has fewer daylight hours during this time because of the angle of the sun. This hemisphere would be experiencing winter at this time. Think of it this way. Imagine you're toasting a marshmallow over a campfire. If you hold the marshmallow close up to the flames, it gets hot really fast because it's getting direct heat. That's like summer. The sun's rays hit the ground more directly, making it warmer. But what if you move the marshmallow farther away from the flames? It heats up much more slowly because it's not getting as much direct heat. That's like winter. The sun's rays hit the Earth at an angle, spreading out more so it doesn't get as warm. It's one thing to understand how the angle of sunlight affects temperature, but it's another to see how this affects seasons around the world, like my vacation destination, Ecuador, which is right on the equator. The equator is an imaginary line that runs around the middle of the Earth, dividing it into the northern and southern hemispheres. Because the equator is between the two hemispheres, it always gets the same amount of direct sunlight, no matter where Earth is in its orbit. That's why it stays warm all year long, even in December, when some other places, like where I am, are freezing. And since the amount of direct sunlight stays nearly the same, Ecuador has 12 hours of daylight and 12 hours of night every single day. Compare this to a place north of the equator, like Maine in the northeastern United States. Right now, Earth is in this position in its orbit. Which hemisphere is tilted toward the sun? The northern half or the southern half? Yes, the northern hemisphere. Because Maine is leaning towards the sun, it gets more direct sunlight, which makes it warmer. Which season has the warmest temperatures? That's right, summer. And when Maine is tilted towards the sun, the days are longer. In fact, Maine gets 15 to 16 hours of daylight in summer. But let's see what happens when we fast forward 6 months. Look at the northern hemisphere now. How has the tilt changed? Yes, now it's tilting away from the sun. That means it's getting less direct sunlight and temperatures drop. What season do you think Maine is experiencing now? That's right, winter. Since Maine is tilted away from the sun, it receives less direct sunlight, making the temperatures colder. The sun rises later and sets earlier, which means shorter days and longer nights. In the winter, Maine only sees about 8 to 9 hours of sunlight. But what's happening in the southern hemisphere at this time? It's tilted toward the sun. Take a look at Bolivia, a country in South America. Since Bolivia is now tilting toward the sun, it's receiving more direct sunlight. So people there are experiencing warmer temperatures and longer days. What season would they be experiencing? Yes, it's summer in Bolivia. While the northern hemisphere is in winter, the southern hemisphere is in the opposite season. Fast forward another 6 months, and now Bolivia is tilting away from the sun. With less direct sunlight, temperatures drop and daylight hours shorten. What season has colder temperatures and shorter days? Winter. But of course, seasons don't change overnight. So what happens between summer and winter? Fall and spring. These are transition seasons because they occur as Earth gradually tilts toward or away from the sun, creating a slow and steady shift in temperature and daylight hours. That's why they feel milder compared to the extremes of summer and winter. Look at the northern hemisphere here. Right now, it's spring. That means in the southern hemisphere, it's fall. Even though one hemisphere is heading into warmer weather and the other into cooler temperatures, their daylight hours and overall temperatures are actually pretty similar during these seasons. So, why do we experience fall? Fall begins when a hemisphere starts tilting away from the sun, leading to shorter days and cooler temperatures as sunlight becomes less direct. And why do we experience spring? Spring happens when a hemisphere starts tilting back towards the sun, bringing longer days and warmer temperatures as sunlight becomes more direct again. By the time Earth completes its tilt in either direction, we reach the extremes of summer or winter. But until then, spring and fall gently guide us through the changing seasons. We've seen that places near the equator have very little seasonal change. But as we move farther from the equator, the differences between seasons become more noticeable, gradually increasing from mild variations to dramatic shifts in temperature and daylight. So, where do you think the most extreme seasonal changes happen? That's right, the North and South Poles. During summer, the North Pole is tilted toward the sun for about 6 months, meaning the sun never sets. This is called the midnight sun. But in winter, the North Pole is tilted away, meaning the sun never rises for 6 months. This is called polar night. The same thing happens in the South Pole, but at opposite times of the year. What would you prefer? To live in a place where it's always daytime or a place that's always night? Let's review everything we've learned today. Earth's tilt and revolution around the sun create seasons and affect daylight. When a hemisphere tilts toward the sun, it gets more direct sunlight, leading to longer warmer summer days. When it tilts away, it receives less sunlight, causing shorter, colder winter days. To learn more about the seasons, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. You know what? A warm, sunny vacation in the middle of winter actually sounds like a great idea. Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time! Hey, hey.